Hello, welcome back to Guidancy Education Channel. In this video, we are going to do a few problems related to spherical mirrors. We have already done one or two problems in the previous video. We will continue a few more. Trying out problems will help to reinforce the concepts that we have learned. But before we continue, please watch the video completely, and if you think the video is useful, like the video, share the video, and also leave your comments in the comment box below. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and also press the bell button so that you get intimated as soon as videos are posted. Thank you very much. Let us do this problem. An object is kept in front of a concave mirror of focal length 20 cm. Image formed is 3 times the size of the object. Calculate the possible distance of the object from the mirror. You have to calculate U. F is given. V is not given. You have to calculate U. This you have to do for real image and virtual image. Let us take the case A, that is for real image first. The object lies in front of the mirror, whether it is a concave mirror, convex mirror or a plane mirror. But for real image, the image also lies in front of the mirror. So what happens? The distance U and V become negative. So this is equal to negative U and negative V. What about center of curvature and focus? It does represent the concave mirror. This is the concave mirror. Center of curvature will lie somewhere here, and the focus also will lie somewhere here. So center of curvature and focus lie in front of the mirror. So negative R and negative F. We have these quantities here. The size of the image is thrice the size of the object. So let us take the size of the object H equal to X. Then size of the image H dash becomes 3X. From the formula for linear magnification, we get M is equal to H dash by H, height of the image by height of the object. This is equal to V by U. But in this case, V and U are negative. So we take negative 3X and negative X. Using Lenz formula, we get the expression 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. Substituting the values, you get 1 by negative 20 is equal to 1 by negative 3x plus 1 by negative x. On simplification, this becomes negative x plus negative 3x by negative 3x into negative x. The quantity becomes 1 by negative 20 is equal to negative x plus negative 3x becomes negative 4x by minus into minus becomes plus. So 3x square. This 2 and this x can be cancelled. 3x square is equal to 3x into x, so that x gets cancelled. On cross multiplication, you get 3x is equal to negative into negative, positive, 4 into 20, 80. So 3x is equal to 80. So x becomes 80 by 3, which is equal to 26.67 centimeter. But what is this x? We have already shown that x is equal to u and that u is negative in this case. So negative u is equal to 26.67 centimeter. The object is at a distance of 26.67 centimeter in front of the mirror. That is the meaning of this negative sign. I hope it is clear. Let us pass on to the next section, B. That is for virtual image. For virtual image, the image will be behind the mirror. So that means the measurement will be in a direction similar to the direction of the incident light. So V becomes positive. U and F doesn't change. So they are negative. These things remain common, only the sign convention changes. So 1 by negative F is equal to 1 by V, this is positive, plus 1 by negative U. This becomes 1 by negative 20 is equal to 1 by 3x plus 1 by negative x. We have simplified it the same way as we did in the previous case. But here it is positive. Negative x plus positive 3x. So it becomes 2x. Here it is positive 3x into negative x. So it becomes negative 3x square. So this quantity becomes 1 by negative 20 is equal to 2 by 3x. On cross multiplication, you will get negative 3x is equal to negative 40. This negative and this negative get cancelled. It becomes 3x is equal to 40. So x is equal to 40 by 3. X is equal to 13.33 centimeter. What is x? It is negative u. So negative u is equal to 13.33 centimeters. So in this case, the object is lying in front of the mirror at a distance 13.33 centimeters. We can go a step further and analyze the position in these two cases. For virtual image, the object is between the focus and pole of the mirror. What about this case? In the case of real image, from this we can understand that the object is placed away from the focal length. Okay, I hope it is clear. Let us do one more problem. Find the position of the object for a convex mirror of focal length 20 cm when the size of the image is half the size of the object. It is a convex mirror. For convex mirror, f is equal to positive and here it is given as 20 cm. I have made a representation of the convex mirror here and the center of curvature and the focus lies behind the mirror. So the value of f is positive. V is also positive. For convex mirrors, the image is virtual. A ray of light falls in this line, gets reflected like this. It is extended backwards. It passes through focus. Another ray on the pole of the mirror and it gets reflected like this. And it is extended backward and where they meet, the image is formed here. So this is a virtual image. So it falls behind the mirror. It cannot be caught on a screen. That is why it is virtual. We have already learnt this. So we have negative U and positive V, positive F. That is noted here. We are not given magnitude of V or U. We are only given relative size of the object and the image. If the size of the object is X, size of the image H dash is half the size of object. So it is half X equal to 0.5 X. From equation for linear magnification, H dash by H is equal to V by U. So we can equate H dash with V and H with U. So it becomes equal to 0.5x by x. Here u is negative. So we have taken negative x here. Applying mirror formula, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. Substituting the values we have obtained, it becomes 1 by 20 is equal to 1 by 0.5x plus 1 by negative x. On simplification, it becomes 1 by 20 is equal to negative x plus positive 0.5x divided by 0.5x into negative x. So this quantity becomes negative 0.5. Here it is negative 1x, here it is positive 0.5x. So when these two quantities are added, you get negative 0.5x. 0.5x into negative x, that is 1x. Negative 0.5x into 1, that is negative 0.5x is equal to 20 into negative 0.5, can be written as 20 into negative half. So that quantity becomes negative 20 by 2. So you get negative 0.5x is equal to negative 20 by 2. Again, this 2 can be taken over here. 2 into negative 0.5x is equal to negative 20. From this, 2 into 0.5x becomes 1x. So negative x is equal to negative 20. You have two negatives, one on either side of the equation. So negative can be cancelled. So x is equal to 20. But what is x? We have taken x equal to u. Here u is negative. So negative u is equal to 20 centimeter. So what is the meaning? When we read the question again, find the position of the object for a convex mirror. For the given details, the position of the object is 20 centimeters in front of the mirror. That is what this negative sign tells us. What is the significance of this 20 centimeter? The object is on the focus, because the focus is 20 centimeters. I hope it is clear. We shall try to do one or two problems more in the next video. Thank you.